Right, so our course is 8 in 350, mechanical measurements and metrology. Right, so as per our agenda, today we are going to see the measurement of pressure. Right, so the learning outcome is very simple. At the end of this class, we must know the various pressures and then instrument to measure the pressure. Right, so as per our content, we are going to see this one. So dead weight tensioner, bound and tube pressure gauges, diaphragms and bellow gauges. Right. So the introduction to pressure. So the first thing, the pressure is force exerted by media, usually fluid or unit area. So pressure, at the end of the day, generally it's a force now. But we can't say force. The force means that, you know, it causes a movement. Force, at the end of the day. Force movement, but if I'm giving the object, or if I'm giving the pressure to a particular object, definitely it won't start immediately. It may get some restrictions. ரெஸ்ட்ரிக்ஷனை வச்சுனா என்ன ஆகும் அப்படின்னா நம்மளுக்கு அந்த ப்ரெஷரை கிரியேட் ஆகும். ரைட், ஸோ ப்ரெஷர் இஸ் தி ஃபோர்ஸ் எக்ஸர்டட் பை அ மீடியா, யூஸ்வலி எ ஃப்ளூயிட் ஆர் யூனிட் ஏரியா. ரைட், ஸோ எக்ஸர்டட் பை அ மீடியா. ரைட், ஸோ மெஷரிங் டிவைட் யூஸ் டிஃப்ரென்ஷியல் ப்ரெஷர், ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் காஜ். ஸோ ப்ரெஷர் இக்கட்டு ஃபோர்ஸ் பர் யூனிட் ஏரியா, த ரிலேஷன்ஷிப் பிட்வீன் ஃபோர்ஸ் அண்ட் ஏரியா, த ரெசிப்ரோக் ஃபோர்ஸ் பர் ஏரியா இஸ் நத்திங் பட் அவர் ப்ரெஷர். ஸோ நம்ம மெஷர் பண்ணுற எல்லா ப்ரெஷருமே பார்த்துட்டு அப்படின்னா ஜென்லி இட் இஸ் அ டிஃபரன்ஷியல் ப்ரெஷர்ஸ். ஸோ வாட் இஸ் மீன் பை டிஃபரன்ஷியல் இன் த சென்ஸ், இஃப் யூ கம்பேர் பர்சன் எக்ஸ் அண்ட் பர்சன் ஒய், ஐ கேன் சே பர்சன் எக்ஸ் இஸ் பெட்டர் பிகாஸ் ஐ எம் கம்பேரிங் பர்சன் எக்ஸ் டு பர்சன் ஒய். த சேம் வே, இஃப் ஐ வாண்ட் டு, இஃப் ஐ மெஷரிங் த ப்ரெஷர், ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் ஐ ஹேவ் அ வேரியஸ் ஆஃப் ப்ரெஷர் மெஷர்மெண்ட்ஸ். ஸோ இஃப் ஐ மெஷரிங் சம் ப்ரெஷர், இட் மே ஹேவ் அ டிஃபரன்ஸ். ஸோ ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் த ரீடிங் 10 நம்ம சொல்கிறோம், அதுக்கு 10 பாஸ்கல் அப்படி சொல்கிறோம் அப்படின்னா, it is we referred, we compared 0 to 10. So 0 is taken as a reference value. So the most of the pressures are what we measure is a differential pressure. So differential in the sense, if you compare the two pressures, pressure difference nala varra or value, it's a differential pressure. One of the examples is gauge pressure. You will see that. All right, sorry. Okay, so some of the applications, main applications are, it is IC engine cylinder, because it's a transducer. Engine cylinder, engine is a transducer. It converts fuel energy into mechanical energy. That whole process are carried out inside the cylinder. So it, more temperature variation as well as pressure variation will happen. So we need to control, we need to regulate the pressure. So it is one of the main applications for pressure measurements. So chemical reactions are affected by the operating pressure. These are the summative. And second main application is in our thermal plant. Thermal plant generally they use produce electricity, so with the help of thermal energy. So they, with that, we need to maintain the pressure, because it may get explosive. If we not control our pressure, then it may get explosive. So the main application was only the IC engine cylinder, second is the thermal power plant. Okay, so again, other applications are, we can say, measurement of pressure becomes important aspects with the following reasons. It is a quantity that describes the entire system, right? So for example, if I say the person X is more pressurized to man, which means normally he took all the factors along pressure. For example, 8 hours are working load up, 6 hours could be pressure of equipment. So it defines the system. Our opinion on defined one order also works. The same way, it is a quantity that describes the system. It is invariably a significant process parameter, right? So, because process parameter is nothing but it is a sub quantity which is used to do some process. For example, if you take lathe, assume that if you take a lathe, it will use to for machining process. So machining process use one. The lathe, if you want to operate, you need to control main 3 process parameters, namely lathe, cutting speed, feed, depth of cut. The same way, if you increase the cutting speed, then the temperature will increase, the pressure also increase. So we can't avoid the pressure. So it is invariably a significant process parameter. So the entire system process parameter element depends on the pressure. So many times the pressure depends on the means of measuring a flow rate of the fluid. So we will see the measurement of flow level, where the pressure is used to measure the fluid flow, fluid rate. So many times pressure difference is used by means of a measuring flow rate. Right, so these are the some of the applications. The second, this is we know Pascal law, because pressure changes at any point in a confined incoming fluid is transmitted throughout the fluid such that the same changes across everywhere. So this is one of the important aspects, right? So pressure is the important aspect. Right, so normally we have three types of scales. Right, so we have three types of scales. So if you want to measure the pressure, you can use three types of scales. Like our nominal scale, we have a centimeter, inches, as well as other measurement methods. So in the same way, the measurement values we can define in three ways. Right, so one is the Gauss pressure, absolute pressure, and then vacuum pressures. So the end and characterized by reference pressure. So we have a reference pressure. So normally, pressure measurement scales are, we have a three. One is a Gauss pressure, absolute pressure, and vacuum pressure. Right. So every all pressures requires reference pressure so that we can measure the difference pressure difference measure conundrum. Right. Okay. So these are the some of the scales: temperature scale, Gauss pressure, absolute pressure, vacuum pressure. The readings are different. Right, so the values, the units are differ as well as the values may be differ, but we have a correlation. So we have some mathematical relation between these three. Right, okay. So we will see one by one. This is the introduction of pressure. Right, so first thing, it's absolute pressure. Okay, so absolute pressure is nothing but absolute pressure is nothing but it occurs at a pure vacuum. Right, so pure vacuum la or pressure irukkaruna, we can say it's absolute pressure. If the pressure is measured at pure vacuum. So remember one thing, the pure vacuum killer உங்களுக்கு எந்த ரீடிங்குமே இல்லை. This is the very lower bottom most part, pure vacuum. So we took reference, the pure vacuum லந்து நம்ம reference எடுக்கிறோம். The more than pure vacuum, so the pure vacuum வந்து assume that it's a zero, zero. அதுக்கு மேலே இருக்க எல்லா ப்ரெஷருமே we can say it's a absolute pressure. So reference is absolute zero, it occurs pure vacuum. So absolute zero அப்படின்றது it occurs pure vacuum. So the units are pounds per square inch absolute. That's why we say PSIA. Pounds per square inch absolute. Pounds per square inch absolute. PSIA. So we took absolute pressure அப்படின்றது நம்ம ஒரு ரெஃபரன்ஸ்ல இருந்து மிஸ்டர் பண்ண போறோம். The reference is nothing but our absolute zero. அப்சல்யூட் ஜீரோ அப்படின்றது இட்ஸ் அ பியூர் வேகம் இது கீழே எதுவுமே ரீஜனே கிடையாது இட்ஸ் அ பாட்டம் மோஸ்ட் பார்ட் ஸோ அப்சல்யூட் ஜீரோ இஸ் ரெஃபரன்ஸ் ஃபார் அப்சல்யூட் ப்ரோ இட்ஸ் அ பியூர் வேகம் யூனிட் வந்து பிஎஸ்ஏன்னு சொல்கிறோம் விச் மீன்ஸ் இதுதான் ஜீரோ பிஎஸ்ஏ ஸோ இதுக்கு மேலே இருக்க எல்லாமே பார்த்தீங்க அப்படின்னா வி கேன் சே இட்ஸ் அப்சல்யூட் ப்ரெஷர் அண்ட் வி ஹவ் அ சி லெவல் ரைட் ஸோ சி லெவல் நம்ம இருக்கிறது எல்லாமே சி லெவல் தான் ஸோ சி லெவலில் பார்த்தீங்க அப்படின்னா இட் இஸ் கம்ஸ் வித் 14.7 பிஎஸ்ஐஏ ஸோ அப்சல்யூட் ப்ரெஷர் ஜீரோவில் இருந்து 14.7 வந்து வி ஹேவ் நம்ம இரண்டு சரௌண்டிங்ஸ் வந்து சி லெவலில் இருக்கும் அப்படின்னா 14.7 ஸோ ரெஃபரன்ஸ் இஸ் பியூர் வேகம் ரைட் ஸோ ஓகே ஃப்ரம் திஸ் இமேஜ் அட் சி லெவல் இட்ஸ் அ 14.7A அண்ட் 16,400 feet அபோவ் சி லெவல் இட் இஸ் அ 7.68 பிஎஸ்ஐ ரைட் ஸோ இந்த இமேஜை பாருங்க ஜஸ்ட் லிசன் ஜஸ்ட் வாட்ச் திஸ் இமேஜ் ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் ஜென்ரலி இட் இஸ் அ டிவைஸ் திஸ் இஸ் அ டிவைஸ் ஸோ திஸ் டிவைஸ் யூஸ் டு மெஷர் தி ப்ரெஷர் Right, so just to see this device, it is fully closed. Fully closed, there is no opening. The opening is there, this is a fully closed. So this is, can be considered as a pure vacuum because it's a fully closed one. So in pure vacuum region, we have a spring as well as diaphragm. Spring as well as diaphragm. And so first thing, at sea level, right, so at sea level, the diaphragm is close this opening so diaphragm enna pannu appadina indha opening close panrom at sea level so for this on the close panrala we need to give the spring tension right so we need to provide spring tension so at sea level the diaphragm will close this opening it shows the value as a zero so we took this is our reference if you want to measure at amma inge measure panna pora appadina right so at sea level so this is the sea level sorry at pure vacuum la it shows only zero at sea level la vekkirappa the pressure will different so the ulla cause in the chamber 1 and then chamber 2 the pressure difference between this chamber enna pannu appadina the spring will moves downwards because the pressure vandu zero va irukku இங்கே 14.7 இருக்குது, அப்போ ப்ரெஷர் டிஃப்ரென்ஸ் இங்கே தான் ஹையாக இருக்குது. இந்த செகண்ட் ரீஜனில் இன்லெட் ரீஜனில் ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்காக இட் இட் புஷஸ் தி டயஃப்ராம், இட் புஷஸ் தி டயஃப்ராம், ஸோ த ஏர் இஸ் லீவ் ஏர் இஸ் வெண்ட் ஹியர், ஸோ த ரீடிங்ஸ் ஆர் சேஞ்சஸ். இட் ஷோஸ் த 14.7. த சேம் equipment, if you measure 16,400 feet above sea level, again the pressure is more, then it will reduce. So 7.68 kg, so mele poga kodum korum. So right, so this is one of the measurement devices. Absolute pressure, the main thing is absolute pressure reference is pure absolute, which means pure vacuum, right? So pure vacuum adukila endha region me illa, mele poga ellame absolute pressure. Generally we use this kind of equipment to measure. So, zero la pathinga appadina we the diaphragm will close the opening, so it shows the value zero. If any pressure difference will occur, it pushes the fluid, it pushes the diaphragm, so the values are changing, so we will measure the value. This is what the absolute pressure. The next pressure is vacuum pressure, right? So similarly we have a reference here, also we have a reference. The reference is absolute atmospheric pressure is the reference pressure. Atmospheric pressure is the reference point. So at below atmospheric pressure, all the pressures are we may say as a vacuum pressure, right? So previous case we took pure absolute pure vacuum as a reference, so now but here we took atmospheric pressure as our reference level. At below all pressure below at below absolute atmospheric pressure sea level la irund atmospheric pressure here ellame we can say it's a vacuum pressure, so reduce aite varum. Right, so vacuum pressure again it reaches the pure vacuum kila possibility illa, so in the region we can say it's a vacuum pressure. The units are inches in mercury, so we took this as a reference, so 0 inches, so the values are increasing, so values could have around 29.22 kg. So in the reading pathinga appadina it always lie with 0 to 29.92 inches. 30 inches um povadu minus lie povadu. So inge minus in the sense na bottom la edhaame solren, so bottom na inda direction la undu I took as a positive, right? So 0 la undu 29.92 la edhaadum. Sometimes we use absolute pressure, atmospheric pressure irukum, next pressure paakrappa avanga minus la vacuum solren, otherwise no need to confuse. This is 0, this one is 29, minus 29.92 ni ellame idhukku inda region ku la vacuum pressure will happen, right? So this is another one equipment, right? So pure vacuum, it shows 0 inches, sorry, at sea level pure vacuum it is 29.92 inches, can be measured. The third pressure is a cause pressure. This pressure only we use our pressure measurement. Most of the pressure instruments pathinga appadina we use cause pressure abindrathu generally it's a difference pressures appdi solvanga, pressure difference we will see. So reference is atmospheric pressure, so here also we took the reference is atmospheric pressure level. Like our previous case, vacuum pressure ku enna reference eduthomo adhe maari here also we took atmospheric pressure as our reference, but vacuum pressure indrathu only below region, atmospheric illa below mattum we can say vacuum, but cause pressure abindrathu it have a two direction, so one is a negative, another one is a positive, so the above sea level keela irukkaradhellame we say it's a negative cause pressure. The top of this we say it's a positive cause pressure. So the negative cause pressure pathinga appadina pure vacuum kila po wifi illa, but positive cause it may vary, nariya changes po, right? So is for this reason only if you measure cause pressure equipment use panni nam vacuum pressure measure panna appadina we will took minus nu poduvom, minus 26 minus 77 andha mari poduvom. The units are pounds per square inch causes, psig. So we took this one as a reference, 0 psig, and the bottom is 14.97 psig, and top is top is again we can't predict, it may vary, right? So we have a three types of pressure. One is a absolute pressure, vacuum pressure, cause pressure. Absolute pressure, the reference is pure vacuum, the bottom most to bottom, the top of the all region we can say it's a absolute pressure. The second one is a vacuum pressure, the it is taken as a reference, absolute atmospheric pressure level as our reference. So at below of atmospheric pressure all the pressures we can say it's a vacuum pressure. Cause pressure it is also take atmospheric pressure as a reference, but it may be positive or negative. The positive means the above atmospheric pressure level, we can say it's a positive reference, positive pressure, and the below atmospheric pressure, we can say it's a negative pressure. Right, this is what are three types of pressures, right? So again, this is at sea level, you have a 0 PSIG, at 16,400 PSIG, we have a, right? So we have a negative as well as positive here. 16,400, we have a, some values, right? So look at this device, right? So this is similar to our previous device. Only difference is here we have a opening, which means this is not a pure vacuum. If you close this, so if you close this region, then the pure vacuum that is used for absolute pressure measurement. But here we are going to use cause pressure. The reference point is atmospheric pressure. So we have an opening here. So whenever the pressure on the vapor and atmosphere exceed out, then only the diaphragm will push us downward direction. The fluid flows, so the readings are changes. Right. So this is the cause process. Right. So as we know, we have two types of pressure. Cause pressure, one is a positive, another one is a negative. So cause pressure in the example is a tire. A tire layer, our air supply control, all that comes with the positive cause pressure. The negative is holding the glass. So if you want to hold in the glass seat, you can use negative cause pressure. So and maximum negative is absolute zero. We know that. That is why pure vacuum can occur here. Right, so these are the some of the pressure measurement scale. This is a summary part of pressure measurement scale. So cause pressure is measured above the local atmospheric pressure. So cause pressure in general, like pressure measure control, we will say pressure is the body ke pressure measure control, assume that they said 20 20 40 220 40, and region children are we took the atmospheric sea level. So we have atmospheric pressure level difference, other positive pressure we will consider. Right, so cause pressure is measured above the local atmospheric pressure. Total absolute pressure is the summation of atmospheric pressure plus cause pressure. Right, so the negative cause pressure, they will say vacuum solidaranga, but that is also cause pressure. Right, so if we know atmospheric pressure plus positive cause pressure at Pamapina, we can have a total absolute pressure. So the total absolute pressure is the total pressure measured from zero pressure at the datum point, zero is the datum point. When the absolute pressure exceeds the local atmospheric pressure, it may consider to be the sum of the cause pressure and the local atmospheric pressure. And differential pressure, again, as I said earlier, difference, pressure difference which measure for now, we can say differential pressure. So, differential pressure is the difference in pressure measured between, two points. So, differential pressure is the pressure measured between two points. Right, so when the pressure is to be measured is less than the local atmospheric pressure, it is called vacuum pressure. So negative cause pressure we can take as a vacuum pressure. In other words, when the cause pressure is negative, it is termed as a vacuum. So the vacuum is atmospheric pressure minus absolute pressure. So atmospheric pressure number three, absolute pressure is the full. So entire region atmospheric pressure three, that is positive cause pressure minus atmospheric pressure, total pressure and the absolute pressure minus control, we can get the vacuum. So absolute pressure is measured above total vacuum or zero absolute. So that is the measure point of zero, it's a pure vacuum. Zero absolute reference the total lack of pressure. So this is again another one relation, right? So we have, so here they have a biometric pressure. Biometric pressure is nothing but our atmospheric pressure. The other name of atmospheric pressure is biometric pressures, right? So it may be the 1.034 or 1000 1 lakh and bar 760 m mercury. So we know that this is the top, the below one is a pure vacuum. Absolute pressure, the top region, all absolute pressure. So the P1 or P2, both are the absolute pressure, because the region, the top of the region, zero absolute pressure, mellow yellow region, we can say it's absolute pressure. And we have a barometric pressure. Barometric pressure is nothing but our atmospheric pressure. So we have a negative cause pressure P1 and P2 is a positive cause pressure, atmospheric pressure. So at below, in the negative cause pressure, we can say it's a pure vacuum pressure. Vacuum pressure. So right, so this is some relation of the units, some units of pressure. We know that pressure is equal to force per area, so Pascal is Newton per meter square. One atmosphere is 760 mercury, mm of mercury, or 1.01 × 10^5 Pascal. One mm of mercury is 1 tar. 1 tar is 1.316 × 10^3 atom. 133.3 Pascal, 1 bar equal to 10.5 bar. These are some of the relationships, right? So, right. Okay, so this is what we are seeing. So up to this, we are going to see the pressure introduction. So pressure introduction, assume that introduction of pressure. So which means what type of pressure we have. Pressure in the pressure is okay. We have three types of pressure, the reference value, all those things. Now we are going to see some of the instruments to measure the pressure. Right, so we are going to see some of the instruments to measure the pressure. So one is it's a dead weight tester. Right, so one is a dead weight tester. So a dead weight pressure gauge or piston gauge is a very popular device for measuring static pressure. So dead weight tester is nothing but it is a very popular device. It is used to measure the static pressure. It works on the Archimedes principle. So Archimedes, I hope you know what is meant by Archimedes principle. The air or fluid displaced by the applied weight, the piston exerts buoyant force which causes the gauge to indicate the pressure. So air or fluid displaced by the applied weight. So if I am applying the weight to air or fluid. Fluid is nothing but liquid, so air or liquid. So if I am applying the weight to air or liquid, if I am the piston will exert. So if the closed chamber, we have a liquid, right? So closed chamber, we have air or liquid, it's a fluid. So I have a two opening, one for my force applying, another one for the piston weight. So if I am applying the force, if I am applying the force, if I am applying the pedal inside air or pressure or liquid, it gets displaced. So this displacement is measured to pressure. So dead weight pressure causes are normally used to calibrate other pressure measurement devices. So other devices, other pressure measurement devices can be calibrated with the help of a dead weight tester. So it's a device used for balancing a fluid pressure with the known weight. Right. So it is a device which is used to measure the pressure with the known weight, right? So this is the very, very simplest construction for dead weight tester, right? So this is a very simplest construction. So we have a chamber here. So we have a chamber, and then we have a three ports, three opening. One port for our plunger or displacement pump. One port for displacement or plunger pump. The top of we have a another one port for piston movement. Another one port for piston movement, and the right left side. Left side we have another port to measure the pressure difference. So we have a gauge, pressure gauges we have. Right, so a dead weight pressure gauge comprises of piston is inserted into the closed fitting cylinder. So piston it is fitted with the closed cylinder. The weight of the piston and the cross sectional area of both piston and the cylinder we can calculate. Because the formulas are there, we can easily calculate. The next thing, the next open is and we have a bottom of the dead weight tester, a chamber with the check valve. A chamber with the check valve is provided. So we have a check valve. Check valve acts as a one-way communication or one-way flow. So if the flow is fluid from this direction. So I got my mouse of a telling me like that. So right, if the flow fluid, if fluid flows from chamber to gauges coach of the it won't repeat aagakudadu. Adukaga we use check valve. So check valve it is used for one way flow, right? So the return flow vachina it will arrest. Adukaga we have a check valve. We use a check valve, right? So right, the piston first is removed. So enna pandrom, the piston gear top of the piston, the piston is removed, piston remove pandrom. And then the chamber and the cylinders are filled with the clean fluid with the plunger in the forwarding portion. So now piston I remove one time and the opening open one time, I am inserting my fluids. So now fluids in the chamber will fit one time. At the time the plunger is moved forward of in the region of the top la mele irukkamari, the top la mele irukkamari I will adjust. So the plunger pathinga appadina mele move panniruvom, right? So the entire fluids are filled, the chamber is moved upward direction, the plunger is moved upward direction, right? So next is the plunger is gradually withdrawn and the entire space is filled with it. So forward ingiradhu inge kile kondu varudhu bottom la kondu varudhu again na konjam konjam mele kondu poren. So the entire space ellame it is filled with the liquids la fill panniruvom. The plunger is gradually withdrawn, entire space, the piston is fixed back into the piston. So after filling the fluid I am going to fix the piston. Piston வந்து fix பண்றேன். Fix பண்ணிட்டேன். So என்ன பண்றேன் அப்படினா again the gauge is calibrated and connected to the chamber. So fix பண்ணதுக்கு அப்புறம் without adding any weight without adding any weight என்ன பண்றேன் I'm going to set the value as 0 or I'm going to connect the check it what is gauge check பண்றேன். Again I'm adding the known weight. So I'm adding the known weight. So when weight add பண்ண உள்ள இருக்க pressure வந்து it gets displayed. So automatically the fluid flow பாத்தீங்க அப்படினா it can move this way because we connected the plunger but it can move this way check valve move ஆகும். Again it will pass on to this pipe, the pressure will vary, the gauge indicator will vary. So after adding the known weight I'm giving the pressure to the plunger na maybe bike or car la petrol apply பண்றோமோ the same way I'm going to give the pressure here. So automatically the first thing after adding the weight I'm going to set the value as 0. Known weight add பண்ணதுக்கு அப்புறம் gauge value na 0 set பண்றேன் because after the fluid flow displays ஆகி உள்ள போயிருச்சு it will show the value I'm calibrated to 0 set பண்ணிட்டேன். Now I'm going to add the force. So I'm going to add the force here. So then the 0 value will changes because I'm applying the force, it will again pass on to the fluids. அப்ப எனக்கு என்ன ஆகும் அப்படின்னா the gauge value change ஆகும் so that I can understand the what it is pressure பண்ணலாம் right. So this is what a dead weight tester. Dead weight tester. So how much force I'm applying அப்படின்றது தெரிஞ்சு அப்படின்னா I can easily measure the force because previous the force tension எல்லாமே நம்ம அனலைஸ் பண்ணோம். We will calculate manually, we will calculate cross section area எல்லாமே right. So the known weights are placed on the piston. By means of displacement valve the plunger can move the forwarding portion plus applying fluid pressure to the other end. Pressure is applied gradually until enough force attains to lift the piston and the weight combinations right. So na pressure apply பண்றேன் known weight full ah down la irukum. So na konjam pressure apply பண்ணா எனக்கு weight மேல change ஆகும் because na applying the pressure so weight on the upward direction move ஆகும். At the same way gauge shows the value. So when the piston is floating freely within cylinder system is equilibrium the system pressure. So சிஸ்டம் ப்ரெஷர் பிஸ்டன் வந்து ரொம்ப ஃப்ரீயாக ஃப்ளோ ஆச்சுன்னா ப்ரெஷர் என்ன இன்க்ரீஸ் ஆகலன்னு இருக்கும். இஃப் நான் அப்ளை பண்ணுறப்ப மூவ் பண்ணுறது கொஞ்சம் டைம் ஆகுது ஆர் ஏதாவது ப்ராப்ளம் இல்லையா ப்ரெஷர் வில் கிரியேட் ரைட். ஸோ தஸ் த டெட் வெயிட் டெஸ்ட் ப்ரெஷர் இஸ் கால்குலேட் பை ஃபோர்ஸ் பர் ஏரியா இஸ் நத்திங் பட் அவர் ஃபோர்ஸ் பர் ஏரியா. ஸோ PDW இஸ் நத்திங் பட் டெட் வெயிட் டெஸ்டர். AE இஸ் நத்திங் பட் ஈக்குவலன்ட் ஏரியா ஆஃப் தி பிஸ்டன் அண்ட் சிலிண்டர் காம்பினேஷன் அண்ட் FE இஸ் நத்திங் பட் ஈக்குவலன்ட் ஃபோர்ஸ் ஆஃப் தி பிஸ்டன் அண்ட் வெயிட் காம்பினேஷன். ஸோ அதை பேஸ் பண்ணி கால்குலேட் பண்ணுறாங்க. இஸ் வாட் அ டெட் வெயிட் டெஸ்டர் right. So dead weight tester அப்படின்றது யுனைடெட் remember that drawing and then how it works. Okay, this is the real tester, dead weight tester. So industrial representation of dead weight tester. Okay, the second device is bore and tube pressure gauges right. So the second device is bore and tube pressure gauges. It is also mostly used for pressure measurement in bore and tube. It is developed by E. Borden in 1849. It can be used up to 500 megapascal. So we can measure 500 megapascal up to bore and tube. It is a non-liquid pressure measurement device. Why we say non-liquid means so the previous dead weight tester we use fluids, generally liquids. We use oils to to measure the pressure. You can ask so why we can't use oil? It may be the air கூட யூஸ் பண்ணலாமே. ஏர் பார்த்தீங்க அப்படின்னா இட்ஸ் அ கம்ப்ரஸபிள் ஃபேக்டர். ஸோ நான் ஃபோர்ஸ் அப்ளை பண்ணுறப்ப கம்ப்ரஸபிள் ஆகுது பாசிபிள் இருக்கும். ஸோ வி கேன் கெட் குட் வேல்யூ, குட் எக்ஸாக்ட் ப்ரெஷர் வேல்யூ. ஃபார் திஸ் ரீசன் ஜென்ரலி டெட் வெயிட் டெஸ்டர் வி யூஸ் லிக்யூட்ஸ் ஆர் ஆயில்ஸ் ரைட். ஸோ பட் ஹியர் த பார் அண்ட் டியூப் இஸ் நாட் ஒர்க்ஸ் ஆன் எனி மீடியம், இட் இஸ் ஒர்க்ஸ் ஆன் ஒன்லி ஏர். இட் இஸ் நான் லிக்யூட் ப்ரெஷர் மெஷர்மெண்ட் டிவைஸ். Okay, the construction is very simple. It has a C-shaped hollow tube. It has a C-shaped hollow tube. We say it's a bore tube. The one end of the bore tube is fixed. The bottom of bore tube is fixed. Other end is connected to the other end is the free end and it is connected to the sum of linkages and gearing mechanisms with the pointer value. So one end is fixed, other end is free. The free end is connected with some linkages and gear mechanism and also it is connected with the point we have a scale reading scale. We have a scale reading scale. So the tube is composed C-shaped hollow metal having elliptical cross sections, right? This is an elliptical hollow section. One end of the bottom tube is fixed and it can be used as a pressure inlet. So the fixed inlet, it acts as a pressure inlet. So we measure the pressure and we apply it. The other end is free and closed. The other end is free and it is closed. And also it is connected with the linkages and the pointer. So this is an industrial representation of bottom tube. Okay, so how it works? Right, so how it works? Just listen. So this end is a fixed one, right? This end is a fixed one. This one is a moved one. If I'm applying the pressure here, right, the inlet. If I'm applying the pressure here, what will happen? The C-shaped hollow section will. Now, if pressure apply under the free end will move. Again, now pressure put under the free end. What will happen? The previous the darker line that left. This is the initial position. If I'm giving the pressure here, the initial position may be converted. Like this, and a canal or arena, a bay or hole or circular and a form of armature because this like this end is fixed one, this end is a movable one. I'm giving the pressure here, so our top pressure, so assume that up pressure is put in arena. Then a canal arena in the initial position of free end will changes because of pressure difference. So the values are changes. So because we connected linkages gearing with the pointer. In free end, so if free end changes, then the pointer shows the different value. Pointer shows different value. Why the free end will change if I'm giving the pressure? So if I'm giving the pressure, then only the free end will changes. Then it will. So in displacement, right? So this is one of the main application. Bottom tube causes it used to measure the pressure with the help of displacement of bottom tube. So in the bottom tube kuda displacement vachidha we will measure the pressure. So the displacement of bottom tube is used to measure the pressure, right? The displacement of bottom tube, right? So this is working better due to the applied pressure. The tube straightens out and it tends to occur circular cross section. Thus pressure causes the free end to move because when pressure apply pandrappa circular ah move pandrathu straight ah move pandrathu it is possible. This movement is proportional to the difference between inside and outside pressure, right? So why it will happen? Because of pressure difference, the inside and outside diameter. To measure the pressure movement in of the free end is often magnitude and transmit to the pointer that moves the scale through the linkage and the gearing mechanism. So this movement of free end is taken from the pointer because both are connected with the free end. The pointer indicates the cause pressure since the reference pressure is atmospheric. Because நம்ம அந்த நார்மல் டியூப் வந்து அட்மாஸ்பியர்க்கு தான் யூஸ் பண்ண போறோம். சோ அட்மாஸ்பியர் பிரஷர் நம்ம பிரஷர் டிஃபரன்ஸ் எப்படி மெஷர் பண்றோம்னா அட்மாஸ்பியர் பிரஷர்ல இருந்து மெஷர் பண்றோம். சோ இட் இஸ் a காஜ் பிரஷர். ரைட். The tube shapes பாத்தீங்க அப்படின்னா ஜெனரலி இட் ஹேவ் த ட்விஸ்டட் ஹெலிகலா இருக்கலாம் ஆர் ட்விஸ்டட் ஆர் ஸ்பைரல் ஃபார்ம் இன் சம் பட் இட் இஸ் சிமிலர் டு சி ஷேப். சி ஷேப்ல தான் இருக்கும். ஆனா சி ஷேப்ல ஒரு சிலிண்டர் நார்மல் சிலிண்டரா இல்லாம இட் மே பி சம் ஹெலிகல் ஆர் இட் மே பி சம் ட்விஸ்டட் ஆர் மே பி சம் ஸ்பைரல் ஃபார்ம்ல right, but a shape of it is C shape. We cannot change the shape. The C shape la, the C shape tube, if you remember, it may be a helical or twisted. For higher sensitivity, bottom tube may be formed as a helix containing. So helix la panna or helical la panna, it is higher sensitivity. Sensitivity, you know that if I'm giving the input, how much the output every respond, output every word. Input put on a small input put a small output changes. Sensitivity. If you want more sensitivity, you can use a helical. C-shaped tube. So the materials are generally it is made by the phosphor, bronze, brass, and beryllium copper. Right. So phosphor, bronze, brass, and beryllium copper. So how we choose the material? There are two way, two consideration. One is the range of pressure to be measured. How much pressure we are going to measure? The elastic limit of the material under consideration. Right. So these two terms very very important. என்ன ப்ரெஷர் எவ்வளோ ப்ரெஷர் மேக்ஸிமம் பண்ண போகிறோமோ அதுக்கேற்ற மாதிரி இருக்கும். ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் ஒரு சின்ன எக்ஸாம்பிள் இருக்கு. ஐ எம் கோயிங் டு ஹேண்டில் ஐ எம் கோயிங் டு ஹோல்டு 5 kg ஆஃப் வெயிட் அப்படின்னா ஐ கன் யூஸ் பிளாஸ்டிக் மெட்டீரியல். சோ இன் த சேம் வே ஐ எம் கோயிங் டு ஹேண்டில் 1000 kg அப்படின்னா ஐ கனாட் யூஸ் பிளாஸ்டிக் பிகாஸ் பிளாஸ்டிக் 5 kg வெயிட்டை தாங்காது. சேம் வே ஹவு மச் ப்ரெஷர் யூ ஆர் கோயிங் டு மெஷர். ஸோ பேஸ்ட் ஆன் யுவர் ப்ரெஷர் யூ நீட் டு சூஸ் யுவர் மெட்டீரியல் ரைட். அண்ட் தென் எலாஸ்டிக் லிமிட் இன் த சென்ஸ் ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் பிளாஸ்டிக் ஹேஸ் எலாஸ்டிக் யூஸ் ஆஃப் 5 ஆஃப்டர் தட் இட் வில் க்ரோ. ஸோ வி நீட் டு நோ த elastic limit of the material, right? So the advantages are it is a portable, convenient, no leveling is required. So there is no leveling, limited to static or quasi static movements. So rendu measure pannalam, I am steady and dynamic. Quasi statement appadina slower movement chestunnadu kuda. Accuracy may be insufficient for many applications. It is one of the limitations. Accuracy may be it is widely used in application where inexpensive static pressure measurements are needed. So idu enga use pandrom appadina enak inge illa vandu static ah irukku pressure as well as romba inexpensive edukkoodad appadina I go with bottom tube pressure gauge. Right, so the next measurement device is diaphragm pressure gauges. So this diaphragm pressure gauge only we see earlier in introduction of pressure, the gauge pressure as well as absolute pressure. I show the device diaphragm. So adha enna panna porom. So diaphragm, it is nothing but it is a element in analog pressure gauges combined both chemical seal and pressure gauge into one unit. So pressure sensing using diaphragm technology measures the difference in pressures of the two sides of the diaphragm. So or diaphragm irukku appadina the top of the diaphragm and the bottom of the diaphragm in the rendu kulla pressure difference vechi dhaan we are going to measure the pressure. So it is a it will measure the pressure with the difference between two sides of the diaphragm. As we know, we have three types: absolute gauge and then vacuum. So vacuum we consider panna porudha because negative gauge is we say it's a vacuum, and we have a differential. So where the sensor has to two ports for the measure two different pressures, right? Okay, so just see this drawing. Right, this is one of the diaphragm. So the diaphragm, we have a hole or a inside hole. There is no opening na, then we say it's absolute because inside la pathinga appadina enak air present agadu. So it has a vacuum, it acts as a pure vacuum. As we know, absolute pressure has a pure vacuum as a reference, right? So the inside undu air irukadu because it's a vacuum. Then this kind of diaphragm is used for measure absolute pressure. Here the gauge and differential pressures, we have a opening because atmospheric pressure is the reference point. Atmospheric pressure is the reference point. So this is the gauge design. Okay, so the diaphragm pressure gauges, we have a variety of types, a variety of way to set. Variety of way to set. One is it may be the flat diaphragm, pathinga it may be the flat or it may be the corrugated, it may be the curvature corrugated diaphragms. Right, so the flat diaphragm, it is for better application for small diaphragm deflection device. So it is a better it will give the better application for small diaphragm deflection. So our flat ah use pannom appadina amplification factor is better, but romba small diaphragm deflection la nammala we can measure. Right, so idu eppadi measure pannom appadina again I said clearly there in gauge and absolute pressure. So if apply the pressure here the top side, so the diaphragm will deform, diaphragm will displace. So ஏன் டிஸ்பிளேஸ் பண்ணதுன்னா நான் இங்கே ப்ரெஷர் கொடுக்குறேன், கீழே ஒரு ப்ரெஷர் இருக்குது. த டிஃப்ரென்ஸ் டியூ டு த ப்ரெஷர் டிஃப்ரென்ஸ் ஒன்லி த டயஃப்ராம் பார்த்தீங்க அப்படின்னா இட் வில் வெண்டு. வெண்ட் ஆகிறப்ப ஐ கேன் தட் வெண்டிங் வில் ஷோஸ் டிஸ்பிளேஸ் பண்ணாலும் டிஸ்பிளேஸ்மெண்ட் இஸ் கால்குலேட் அஸ் தி ப்ரெஷர். ரைட், ஸோ இஃப் இட் இஸ் அ கார்ரிகேட்டர் இட்ஸ் அ சிம்பிளிஃபைட், இட் இஸ் ஃபார் லார்ஜ் டிஃப்ளெக்ஷன். ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் ஃபார் லார்ஜ் டிஃப்ளெக்ஷன், ப்ரீவியஸ் இஸ் அ ஸ்மால் டிஃப்ளெக்ஷன். ஹியர் வி ஹேவ் அ லார்ஜர் டிஃப்ளெக்ஷன் யூஸ் இன் ஸ்டாட்டிக் ப்ரெஷர் மெஷர்மெண்ட்ஸ் டியூ டு தியர் இன்க்ரீஸ் த சைஸ் அண்ட் டிஃப்ளெக்ஷன் விச் அஃபெக்ட் இன் த டைனமிக் ரெஸ்பான்சஸ். Right, the next one is a simple diaphragm. Here we use a fixed view. So the both end of diaphragm is connected with the fixed end. Both end of the diaphragm is connected as a fixed end. Right, so if I apply the pressure, the P, I am applying the pressure P1. Again here we have the bottom side, we have other pressure, bottom side we have other pressure. The difference between this P1 and P2, it will cause the deflection of diaphragm. So we can measure the we can calibrate this deflection as the value. Every deflection varudho adha vachi readings la we can easily measure. So it is the simplest form in showing figure. It is a thin flat circular plate fixed at the two ends. Upon amplification pressure, it will be deflect the resulting differential pressure is given by P1 minus P2. So deflection of nothing but P1 minus P2 can be used to relatively small movements wherein the relation between pressure and deflection is linear. So for practical application, some modifications are required. So for modification, we need to modify. Again, so this is another one type. It's a fabric diaphragm. Fabric diaphragm. So fabric diaphragm. We have a diaphragm, but the diaphragm is connected with the two. The end of the diaphragm is connected with the fabric material. So previous case, the end is connected with the fixed end. When we make fixed end, what do we do? We connect it. Now, our fabric layer is connected. Why we do? Abina, some application requires central measure. Right, so we have two fixed points, and the deflection goes. So sometimes your mechanical linkage system needs to be connected to the diaphragm at center. So diaphragm center la connect pandrathu sometimes it required. For this reason the metal disc is it is connected with the end of the metal disc is connected with the two fabric material. That material, it may be the nylon, diaphragm material may be the nylon, plaster, leather, silk or rubberized fabric. These are some of the materials. It comprises the rigid center base. It comprises the rigid center base. It is held on either side by the diaphragm made by the fabric. So this is also diaphragm down. Fabric also diaphragm down. It's like a corrugated. This is a flat. So flat ayum corrugated ayum joint bond appadina we can say it's a fabric diaphragm. The combination of flat and the corrugated. Right, so mechanical linkage system or recording pen is connected to the center. So இங்க வந்து என்ன பண்றோம் அப்படினா the deflection measure பண்றதுக்கு I'm going to connect recording pen. Pen அப்படிங்கிறது ஒரு pointer or pen pointer. So if the pressure P1, if I'm giving the pressure here P1, so the corrugated as well as flat diaphragm will deflected. That deflection is measured with the secondary tension, is called recording pen. Recording pen ல measure பண்ணிக்கலாம். That deflection can be calculated as a pressure. Right, the slack diaphragm is to measure low pressures. Right, the next type is pressure capsule or metal capsule. Right, so this is again the construction is different. Right, the working is same only. Due to the pressure difference, diaphragm will deflect. This deflection is calibrated as the pressure. Right, so construction wise it is different. Right, so we have a rigid center, but we have a corrugated. But instead of straight corrugated, we have a like this type of construction. Right, this is what a pressure capsule or metal capsule. It can be formed by joining two or more diaphragms. Right, it can be joined by two or more diaphragms. Used for corrugated diaphragms, increase the linear deflection and reduces stress. So linear deflection you reduces stress. It can be seen that differential pressure can be created by applying one pressure from inside the capsule and another from the outside. Right, so one side of the inside to another side outside. It is a metallic capsule. Right, so the advantages are it has a much faster frequency response than U-tubes or other C-tubes, right? According accuracy up to 0.5% of full scale, good linearity when the deflection is no longer than the other order of the diaphragm thickness. From the limitation is it is more expensive, right? So next one is a metallic bellows. Bellows is nothing but our tube marika. Bellows, the construction wise it's a tube. So this is again we have a tube. The tube acts as a diaphragm. It is a corrugated diaphragm. The top of we have a metal, right? The again here also the construction is different. So it can be employed as a pressure sensing element. A thin walled tube is converted into the corrugated diaphragm. Corrugated diaphragm by using a hydraulic press and extractor. So it is made by the hydraulic press. Due to the pressure difference, there will be a deflection at Y0. So P1, P2. Due to the pressure difference, Y0 deflection will occur. So under deflection, we can calculate as our pressure. Normally, materials such as phosphor, bronze, brass, beryllium, copper, and stainless steel are used for making a bellows. Metallic bellows are often associated with the zero drift and hysteresis problem. Again, you know the zero drift, right? The initial arc of a zero value is not output to zero. That is a zero drift. So, no zero drift because the hysteresis problem. So, hysteresis means that the value, if I increase one type or another, output will increase. If I again I decrease the input, that is not. போன அவுட்புட் என்ன வச்சோ அதே டிகிரீசிங் அவுட்புட் வரணும் ஆனால் வராது அதான் ஹிஸ்டெரிசிஸ் பட் ஹியர் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா வி கேன் அவாய்ட் தி ஹிஸ்டெரிசிஸ் ப்ராப்ளம் ரைட் ஸோ ஃபைனல் ஒன் இஸ் இண்டஸ்ட்ரியல் கால்ஸ் ஆர் இண்டஸ்ட்ரியல் பெல்லோஸ் ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் யூஸ் டு ஃபார் மெஷர் டிஃபரன்ஷியல் ப்ரெஷர் அகெயின் த கன்ஸ்ட்ரக்ஷன் இஸ் டிஃபரன்ட் வி ஹேவ் அ டூ கார்கேட்டட் டூ பெல்லோஸ் வி ஹேவ் அ டூ பெல்லோஸ் ரைட் ஸோ த ப்ரெஷர் P1 இஸ் P2 ஸோ இஃப் த சென்டர் பைப் சென்டர் ரிஜிட் ஸ்ட்ரக்சர் வி ஹேவ் அ செகண்ட் ட்ரான்ஸ்யூசர் கால்ட் recording pen, it is connected with the center of the diaphragm. So if the pressure is vary, P1 and P2 vary, except na, like the diaphragm will changes, so the deflection will record in the pen. So modification of metallic bellows for differential pressure measurement is known as the industrial cause. One end of the double bellow is connected to the pointer. A high pressure P2 and low pressure P1 are applied to create differential pressure. So it may be different. The percent difference is wrong, and the percent difference which we can make. All right, so thank you. This is what pressure measurement.